when I did it. And you know, part of it is the patience and the things. For all I know, that guy just got called. He's got 2 months to live. And he stopped at the grocery to get a couple things, and he didn't know how to go home and tell his wife. Right? Because instantly you hear the story, you think he's a jerk. Maybe he's got all that going on. Maybe something happened, he went to work yesterday, or the day happened, and lost his job. He's going to go home and tell his wife he's not sure they're going to lose their house, how they're going to continue to buy the kids' clothes. See, when you can start thinking like that, that's the Holy Spirit maturing you, growing in you, and the fruit is starting to come out of you because you become so much more loving. So the question we have today is the Spirit living in you? Because the Holy Spirit is interesting in the fact that the Holy Spirit is not Satan. The Bible says that love is not rooted. Satan just comes in and possesses. The Holy Spirit has to be invited. And have you ever asked the Holy Spirit to come and live inside of you? Because he won't continue to do that. People say, well, that's just a figure of speech. It's just, no, it's just the truth. I love the minister named Stephen Oliver. He's a great, great guy. He taught like Billy Graham, and he taught Chuck Swindoll and all kinds of people when they were back in college. And he was just a great, great teacher. He told about this guy who was preaching in Washington, D.C. They had 6,000 people a week in church. And he preached for a year, and not a single person gave their life to Christ. And he went up to Stephen, and he said, I'm quitting. I'm a horrible preacher. And he says, what makes you say that? And he said, I'm killing myself. I'm writing great sermons. And nobody ever comes to Jesus. Nobody ever. And Stephen looked at him and said, have you ever asked God to quit letting you preach and to fill you with his Holy Spirit and let your Holy Spirit preach? And this guy said, no, I've never prayed. And he said, I suggest you pray on Sunday. And so the guy got down his knees before he went out on the pulpit to pray. And he says, just let me be a conduit for your Holy Spirit. Just use me. Silence me. Take me away. Let the Holy Spirit speak through me. And he gave the invitation of that's the fruit of the Spirit. That's the Spirit coming through. Not the person, not me, not what I am, but the Holy Spirit that lives inside of me. If you want that living in you today, we offer you to come and take, come and pray. If you stand and come while we sing.
Thank you. for communion this morning, I'd like everyone to know that we have an open communion and everybody is welcome to partake. I have just a very short meditation. For some, the service of communion is just a time in which bread is eaten and juice is taken and the soul never stirs, but it wasn't intended to be that way. In Matthew's account of the Last Supper, one incredible truth surfaces. Jesus is the person behind it all. He selected the place, he designated the time, and set the meal in order. And at the supper, Jesus is not the served, but the servant. It is Jesus who put on the garb of a servant and washed the disciples' feet. Jesus is not portrayed as the one who reclines and receives, but as the one who stands and gives. He still does. The Lord's Supper is a gift to you. The Lord's Supper is a holy invitation. A sacred sacrament bidding you to leave the chores of life and enter his splendor. He meets you at the table. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so very much for the wonderful gift that you gave us in that you allowed your Son to be born of a virgin, to come to earth, to grow, to preach, and to give his life for us on the cross that we might have eternal life. And as we partake this morning of the bread and of the cup, let us remember that we are taking his body and his blood that we might have eternal life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.
way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you."
Accept these offerings in Jesus' name.